Well, when a local at Thredbo mentioned to me there was a Schnapps making distillery on the road back to Jindabyne, I thought to myself, this is an important story. This is one I have to cover.
And this is an international alpine story that links two mountain areas, the Tyrol of Austria and the New South Wales Alps. Brad Spalding went to Austria to teach skiing, married a local instructor, Monika, and eventually added Schnapps maker to his CV. Brad and Monika have realised a dream in establishing their own award-winning distillery here in Australia.
Yeah, absolutely.
Come in and have a Schnapps.
Oh, yes, please. Yeah.
Monika's family were farmers and bakers and candlestick makers and Schnapps makers. You know, like all Austrian farmers, they dealt in primary production and in tourism. And that's how the Tyrolean families work. So I got involved in that side of tourism, which meant distilling alcohol.
Your family has been farming for generations, is that right?
I come from a little village and we grew apples and pears and plums and anything what, you know, grows in the mountains where it's cold and you don't get very good grapes. You don't get grapes, so you don't get any other high quality fruit. So they fermented the fruit, and I remember when we were little kids, then one person in the village had a still, and then you got taken the fruit to that man, and he distilled it for everyone, and then you got your schnapps back.
Your family are fairly local to this region, is that right?
Yeah, the Albury region, so on the other side of the mountains. On my father's side, they used to come up into the mountains on this side, so they were farmers just over between Corryong and Albury, used to move freight through that area as well. There was always a bit of fruit involved as well, because then my father and my uncle Angus started a fruit shop in Albury. Yeah, I started in Falls Creek as an instructor when I was 15.
15?
Yeah. There was a lot of Austrian influence in the ski schools in those days. And that was where the connection with Austria started, was just through that ski school connection. And they said, oh, well, look, when you finish school, you should come to Austria. And then I went to Austria, and there was not only skiing, they also made schnapps. So I thought, this is good, you know, the fruit connection, the skiing connection, the whole bit.
So Monika, in your family, what were the really good flavours?
We mainly made obstler, which is the different fruit together. Like you had apples, plums, and that's what you got the most. And then we had this Vogelbeer, which is a berry, a wild berry. You can't eat it, but you make schnapps out of it. And for my tasting, it doesn't taste very good. It's like medicine. But people would sell a bottle of schnapps for, when I was a kid, for 1,000 shillings, which is about $140 now. Because the berries were hard to get, we had to be careful that the birds didn't get them, but you could not eat them, and they were on trees. They made schnapps out of edelweiss, you know, the Austrian flower, but all this sort of schnapps was very, very disgusting to drink. I didn't like it.
Is that getting a bit desperate when you start making schnapps out of edelweiss?
No,
Vogelbeer schnapps is still a very popular schnapps in the Tyrol. It's just, if we had it for sale here in our Australian distillery, we'd sell, we wouldn't sell any. I'd say, unless we got some Austrians in, some Tyroleans came in, maybe we'd sell some. But it's a traditional thing. It's like Vegemite for those guys, you know. Like no, a lot of people don't like eating Vegemite.
We haven't grown up on that. I didn't get that every day on my bread.
They dip their dummies in Vogelbeer schnapps and they acquire a taste for it. That's my theory.
Oh, no.
après ski was a big thing. So if you taught Germans, and where we worked was, well, majority of our guests were German, some Dutch, but and they all were just full on après ski. And if you were their ski instructor, they'd just sort of insist that you were a part of that whole experience. In Australia, people have a drink after skiing because it's a part of the holiday, but it's not sort of ingrained or sort of a part of that whole skiing culture. It is certainly there, but in Europe, it's sort of like a must-do. You know, you ski and you drink schnapps. What's been really important is the supply of fruit that is tree ripened and high in sugar, and just getting really good quality produce in at the beginning of the process. Like making good wine, you need to start with a very good fruit.
It's not only about schnapps making. Brad is a very keen artist, and he and Monika grow much of their own fruit, and they've carefully considered the aesthetics of their environment. One of the distillery's features is a highly weather-resistant granite sculpture garden.
We've used a lot of recycled timber in the distillery as well, in the building and in the structure of the building, and tried to combine recycled timbers with glass, and so that it highlights the still itself, which is, I think, a piece of sculpture in its own right. You know, it's a beautiful piece of crafted copper and stainless steel. I can't imagine really, living away from the mountains. My wife's from the mountains, and she always talks about going to the coast and having something at the coast. But underneath, I don't know whether that's really in either of us, especially, Monika being a native Austrian. They are real mountain people. They don't travel. They just farm and stay in the mountains. And I think I'm a bit like that too. I just like living here.
One of the perks of the job, of course, is you have to taste the end product.
Prost! Yeah, Prost!